And we get ready to go to grade in the 3X out of Blue Ridge, Georgia. The Warrior Twigs, Boats Free Service, Rebel Pantry sponsored entry for Bo Eaton out of Blue Ridge, Georgia. And he'll be joined by the driver of the 22, the Mark Rowland Longhorn, Vic Hill, Rowland Tire, Bo Jangles, Famous Chicken and Biscuits, Jeff Smith Racing sponsored entry for Jasper, Georgia's Will Rowland. Bo Eaton first lap, 14.758, 14.758. First lap for Will Rowland, 13.732, 13.732. Bo Eaton coming down to complete lap number two. 14.730, 14.730. And Will Rowland, 13.966, 13.966. So Will Rowland sets the mark to beat right now in Group A at 13.732. Is our next two roll on the racetrack, the 116, the Longhorn by Weaver, Andy Durham, Powered CrossFit, Overton, A.F. Stone, Professional Medical Services, Mission Transport, Stone, Land Clearing and Excavating Entry for Evans, Georgia's Brandon Overton. He'll be joined by the young man in the 66th, the Bruce Bill Rocket Custom, Nose Racing Parts, Berry Construction, General Contractors, Turbo Logging, Newton's Record Service, sponsored entry for Rome, Georgia's Jake Knowles. First lap for Overton was a 13.650, 13.650. Knowles will go 13.869, 13.869. Overton lap number two. Better quick time of the night, 13.444, 1-3 triple fours for Overton. And Knowles on his second lap, 13.852. So Brandon Overton, top of the leaderboard right now at 13.444. Next two cars roll it out. See the 18X, the Troy Barrett owned Stinger, Andy Durham, Powered Barrett Transport, Elite Concrete, Barrett Towing, TNT Trucking, sponsored entry for Douglasville, Georgia's Mark Page, or Michael Page, and he's going to be joined by the T1, the Platinum Phantom Powered A1 Plus Collision Center, the Allen's Pools, A&K Transport, sponsored entry for East Ridge, Tennessee's Todd Morrow. First lap time for Michael Page, 13.669, 13.669. Todd Morrow on his first lap, 13.878, 13.878. And a Michael Page, 13.725, 13.725, second quick now for Page in Group A. And Morrow coming down to complete his second lap in Group A at 13.827, 13.827. So Overton and Page, first and second so far here in Group A. Next two rolling out, see the 18, the Sweet Bloomquist, Clements, Power Kinzer Drilling Company, Quality Natural Gas, Bill Kinzer Foundation for Autism Research, Pixtron Off-Road sponsored entry for Lexington, Kentucky's Brandon Kinzer. He'll be joined by the young man in the 44, the GRT CT525 powered Wood Hollow Cabinets, Doug Kilgore Motorsports sponsored entry for Dalton, Georgia's Colby Kilgore. As a Kinzer smacks the concrete coming off four, and that'll slow him to 14.232, 14.232. Colby Kilgore on his first lap, 13.305. Kinzer looking to try to better himself here on lap number two. He'll tie him in at 13.914, 13.914. Put Kinzer into six quick. And Colby Kilgore in the 44. 13.968, a bit better. 13.968 for Kilgore on lap number two. Next car out. See the 70, the Arnold's Trucking, Blunt Excavating, Cherokee Millwright sponsored, Rocky Vickhill powered entry for Dawsonville, Georgia's D. McDonald McIntosh, and the 29M, the Sweet Bloomquist, Andy Durham, Bob's Towing, Dalton Discount, Carpet Center, McPherson Diesel Truck Specialist entry for the veteran, Gary McPherson out of Dalton, Georgia. Donald McIntosh, lap quick time at 13.399, 13.399. Gary McPherson, 14.063, 14.063. McIntosh 13.373, even better, 13.373 on a second lap. Quick time for McIntosh. McPherson 13.949, 13.949, but put the 70 on Donald McIntosh atop the leaderboard now here in Group A time trials. As our next two roll it out, the unsponsored Warrior Race Engine Design powered entry of the B25 for Dalton, Georgia's Jerry Bradley in a B25. And he'll be joined by the driver of the number 10, the Rocket Chassis. Panama City Cycles sponsored entry for the driver out of Panama City, Florida. That is Ryan Crane in the number 10. Jerry Bradley, a B25, down to complete his first lap of the night. He'll go 14.518, 14.518 on lap one for Jerry Bradley. Ryan Crane in the number 10. He is a first lap. Going to be 14.395, 14.395. And Jerry Bradley, lap number two coming up. Here he is at 14.768, 14.768. And Ryan Crane times in on lap number two. at 14.450 with 12 of the 21 cars in a Group A. Having timed in already. Next two qualifiers out. See the driver of the G9 machine. That is Dallas, Georgia native Eric Granger in the G9. He's going to be joined by last night's winner at Crossville Speedway in the Longhorn Cornette powered Rum Runner Racing Black Rifle Coffee Company Molecule Sports entry for Concord, North Carolina's Joey Coulter. First lap time for Eric Granger, 14.137, 14.137. Joey Coulter, the former Camping World NASCAR Truck Series competitor, 13.934, 13.934. Eric Granger, lap number two, here he is, 14.210, 14.210. Joey Coulter in the black deuce, rolling off turn number four to the checkered flag. He'll go 13.872, 13.872. Coulter will go in to the lucky seventh position with 14-21 timed in. Next two cars rolling out, see the 87, the TNT, Phillips Race Engines, Littleton General Contractors, Adams Automotive and Performance, Finish Line, Race Park, Shorty Shocks, Elite Wrap, sponsored entry for Chatsworth, Georgia's Andrew Littleton in the 87. He's joined by the driver of the 56, the TNT, J&A Machine, J&A Machine Shop, sponsored entry for Teleco Plains, Tennessee driver, Joey Standridge, currently fourth in series points. First lap time for Littleton, 14.484, 14.484 for Littleton on lap number one. Lap number one for Standridge, 15.000, 15 flat for Joey Standridge. Lap number two for Littleton, he'll time in 15.013, 15.013. And Standridge, his second lap, going to be much better at 14.344, 14.344. See the driver, the 7G, the EcoPest rocket chassis entry for the veteran out of Cleveland, Tennessee. That is Craig Greer in 7G. And he'll be joined by the driver in the 17R, the Bruce Built Rocket Kings Custom Powered Wimpson Country, Wimpson County Septic Trace Construction. Andy's towing Cozy Barbecue and Dixon Plumbing entry for Spring Hill, Tennessee's Brad Skinner. Craig Greer on lap one, 14.966, 14.966. Brad Skinner, his first lap, 14.303, 14.303. Craig Greer working the top side off turn four to complete lap number two, 15.226, 15.226. And lap two for Spring Hill, Tennessee's Brad Skinner. It'll be a 13.590. Good lap for Skinner. Put him into position number three here in Group A time trials with three cars remaining. Next two cars out, see the former multi-time Southern All-Star Racing Series champion, Lynette Capital, Big Hill Powered American, Billet Austin Trucking, Competition Racing Equipment, RH Designs, Tucker's Mobile Home Service, sponsored entry for Ooltewah, Tennessee's Riley Hickman, and he'll be joined by the young man in the 41R out of Ackworth, Georgia, the Capital Race Cars Cornette Powered, Clinton Cash, Cox Interior, sponsored entry for TJ Reed. First time for Hickman, 13.852, 13.852. Lap number one for Ackworth, Georgia's TJ Reed, 13.674, 13.674. Lap number two for Riley Hickman. He'll go 14.047, 14.047. And lap two for TJ Reed in the 41R. 13.743, 13.743. Put Reed into position number five. And the final car in Group A, the driver of the 38, feature winner last night at Tri-County Racetrack in Brasstown, North Carolina. In the Masters Built Andrews Engine Service Powered Interstate Welding Oliver Logging Concrete Pumping Incorporated Peachtree Lumber Sponsored Entry from Murphy, North Carolina's Jamie Oliver in the number 38, currently third in series points coming into the ninth action here at North Georgia Speedway. His first lap, 14.239, 14.239 on lap one for Jamie Oliver. As he'll work off turn number two down the back straightaway for the final time. And make his way off turn at number four and complete his second lap at 14.747, 14.747. That'll do it for Group A. 13.373, 13.373. Overall top qualifier in Group A at 13.373. In the 7 a.m. out of Dawsonville, Georgia, big round of applause for D-Mac Donald McIntosh. And our first two qualifiers out, see the 31, the Longhorn by Madden, Clements Powered, Newwood Plumbing, Machine Construction, Queen Realty Team, Hickson Construction, entry for Kingston, Georgia's Tyler Millwood. He'll be joined by the driver of the 101 out of Talbot, Tennessee, the Rockets, Clement Powered, entry of Forrest Trent. Lap one for Tyler Millwood. And they did not get Millwood on that first lap. Forrest Trent, 13.983. Tyler Millwood, 13.605. And Forrest Trent, 13.848 for Forrest Trent and the Service 101 Trent logging. Awesome design concepts. Max Dog sitting. Hobson Race Parts, Bruce Peel Performance sponsored entry for Forrest Trent. Tyler Millwood in the 31 does have one more lap to get, as he did not pick up on the transponder that time by. And Millwood will work it off turn number four to complete his second lap now. And it'll be a 13.431. 13.431. So Tyler Millwood out of Kingston, Georgia sets the mark to beat here in Group B at 13.431. Next two cars out. New driver of the Barry Wright House car. Two consecutive runner up finishes in that Barry Wright icon. Kenny Lamb powered. CNH Paving, BA Pallet Division, H&O Hauling, Felony Farm sponsored entry for Clover, South Carolina's Ross Bales. And he'll be joined by the driver of the 1C, the Longhorn, Atkins Race Engine, Dockery Specialized Transport, Southeast Miscellaneous Erectors, Colin Sines entry for Kenny Collins out of Cobourg, Georgia. Ross Bales, 13.868 on his first lap. Kenny Collins, 15.218. And lap number two for Ross Bales, 13.803, second quick now in Group B. Yeah, and Kenny Collins on his second lap, much better at 14.444.
That's cool.
Next two cars out. First driver out of St. Augustine, Florida, the Longhorn, Andy Durham-powered Bozard. Ford Lincoln, Quick Lane, Tire and Auto Center, Penske Shops, Ocean Grove RV Supercenter sponsored entry for Blake Spencer out of St. Augustine, Florida. He had his first lap. Will be a 14.149 in the J0 out of Cleveland, Tennessee. The Longhorn CT525 Power, Sam's Restaurant Supply, Frazier Apartment Rental, M&S Motor sponsored entry for John Owenby at 13.839 for Owenby. That's third quick. Spencer 14.465 on his second lap. John Owenby lap number two, 13.696, and that is second quick for John Owenby. Next two drivers out. See the driver of the 84, the Capital Clements Powered ETI KSD Custom CSE Penske Shocks entry for Rome, Georgia's Austin Smith. And he'll be joined by the young man in the 157 machine, the Rocket XR1 Cornette Powered Delco Equipment RS Trading Company, Midwest Sheet Metal, Sunoco Race Fuels entry for the Winfield Warrior, Mike Marlard out of Winfield, Tennessee. Austin Smith's first lap, 14.047. Mike Marler, 13.489, second quick now for Marler in Group B. Smith for second lap, 13.978. He had a Mike Marler, 13.665 for Marler. For Marler's first lap, good enough to put him into second quick so far in Group B, behind a top qualifier right now in Group B, Tyler Millwood. Next two cars out. See the 101, the Longhorn Clements Powered Cushman Paint and Body, M&S Concrete, Shaver Racing Oil sponsored entry for Toccoa, Georgia's Casey Roberts. And he'll be joined by the young man in the number 14 machine out of Chatsworth, Georgia, the Kryptonite Race Engine Design, Gene Racing Supply, Sample Masters, Wicked Race Bodies, Outing Race Products entry for Aaron Wilson out of Chatsworth, Georgia. Roberts first lap, 13.763. Aaron Wilson's first lap, 14.336. Casey Roberts lap number two, 13.719. Fourth quick for Roberts in Group B right now. Aaron Wilson's second lap, 14.282, with 10 of the 22 cars in Group B timed in. Whew. Next two getting set to roll out. Going to be led out by the National Dirt Late Model Hall of Famer in the 31. The Stanley Best on GRT, J. Dickens powered. Stanley Best Heating and Air, Curtis Racing Equipment, Renegade Race Fuel and Performance, All-Star Performance sponsored entry for Georgetown, Tennessee, Skip Arp. And he'll be joined by the driver, the number eight, the racing school teacher and coach in the Capital, J. Dickens powered Gibson Motorsports Paint Excavating Interstate Welding entry for the school teacher and coach David Payne out of Murphy, North Carolina. Skip Arp's first lap was 13.997, 13.997. David Payne's first lap, 14.144, 14.144. Skipper coming up on lap number two. Here he is, a former Extreme Series winner here at North Georgia Speedway at 14.262, 14.262. And the current series points leader, David Payne, second lap, 14.076, 14.076. 10 cars remaining to time in. Next two out and going to be led out by the unsponsored number 14, the GRT Custom Race Engines powered entry for Chatsworth, Georgia's Johnny Clore in the 14. And he'll be joined by the young lady in the number 23, the Warrior ECR powered TGN, Larry'sFun.org, a Grizzly Cooler, Textron Off-Road sponsored entry for the 16-year-old out of Evans, Georgia, Anna Parkhurst. First lap for Johnny Clore, 14.167, 14.167, Parkhurst. Bobble a little bit in turn two, gather it back up and get a good run here on lap number two. 15.358, 15.358. She's better through turn two this time. Yes, Clover second lap, 14.125, 14.125. And Miss Anna Parkhurst rolling off turn number four to complete her second and final lap at 14.545, 14.545. Next two out, see the number 99, the Longhorn Vic Hill powered Ellis Contracting Incorporated AutoZone Based Racing Fuels Jeans Racing Parts entry for Chatsworth, Georgia's Derek Ellis and the number 99. And he'll be joined by the driver, the number 29, the Longhorn BME Performance powered Hidden Hollow Motorsports C&J Trucking Competition Racing Equipment Sexton Construction sponsored entry for Maryville, Tennessee's Jason Welshin. First lap time for Derek Ellis, 13.742, 13.742. Fifth quick for Ellis so far in Group B. Jason Welshin, 13.671, 13.671. Put Welshin into third quick so far in Group B. Ellis, 13.995, 13.995. So he'll set six quick right now in Group B. Welshin on lap number two, 13.573, 13.573. Jason Welshin, third quick at this point in Group B, with 16 of the 22 cars in Group B timed in. Next two cars out. First driver going to be led out by the driver out of Signal Mountain, Tennessee. And Platinum Mike Coulter, Vincent Pirate of Playtime Amusement, Biddy Trucking, Andy Dill Trucking, Rick Coulter Race Car sponsored entry for Heath Heineman out of Signal Mountain, Tennessee. And he'll be joined by the driver in the number 53, the Wind Motorsports Capital, Andy Durham powered, Dublin Windwater, Heartland EMS, American Racer Schaefer Oil sponsored entry for the Brasstown, North Carolina native, the Tar Heel Tiger, Ray Cook. Heath Heineman's first lap was a 14.214, 14.214. Ray Cook, 13.938, 13.938 on his first lap. Heath Heineman, lap number two, 14.262, 14.262. And Ray Cook, lap number two, 14.071, 14.071. Next two rolling out, going to be led out by another National Dirt Late Model Hall of Famer in that number 85, the Capital Race Car, Josh Roberts Trucking, Gina Jeans Race Parts, Tyndall & Son Carpet. Capital Race Car sponsored entry for the Chattanooga Flash out of Chattanooga, Tennessee, Ronnie Johnson. And he'll be joined by the young man in the number 8 machine out of Winchester, Tennessee. That is Jaden Freeman, number 8. Lap number 1 for Ronnie Johnson coming up. 13.877, 13.877. Jaden Freeman, that Capital Jackson's Auto Repair, Poultry Electric, and Pro Hardware sponsored entry. 13.933, 13.933. Johnson's second lap, 13.918, 13.918. And Jaden Frame out of Winchester, Tennessee, coming down to complete his second and final lap, 14.044, 14.044. And our final two cars of the evening here in AB Group Time Trials. See the 17M inducted into the National Dirt Late Model Hall of Fame last weekend in Florence Speedway. And the Sweet Blomquist Clements Power Textron Off-Road Cosmetic Gaskets, Klotz Lubricants, Kinzer Drilling Company sponsored entry for Chickamauga, Georgia's Mac Daddy Dale McDowell. And in the 201, the Vanover Racing Longhorn Custom Power and Harrison Ready Mix Vanover and Sun Concrete entry for Knoxville, Tennessee's Billy the Kid, Billy Ogle Jr. Dale McDowell, 13-486. Put Mac Daddy into second quick in Group B. Ogle, 14-044. Lap number two for McDowell coming up, 13-577. And the final lap for Billy Ogle Jr., 14-027. So your top qualifier in Group B at 13-431. For the drivers fastest in that group in the 31 machine. Out of Kingston, Georgia, big round of applause for Tyler Millwood.